Hey guys, what's up, y'all? If y'all don't wonder what, if you get and three spins on your first two, on your first two way playbook, and then on the third one, I mean, and then if you don't like your first two, and then on the third one, you have to stay with that team. It's a 7-game series because they are just got in like a fight for some reason. Maybe voice is being shared right now, baby. All right, so don't say nothing done. Let me stand up for this. If I start losing, I'm gonna stand up. I'm way too uncomfortable right now. Why do you keep laughing, dog?
Texans, Bengals, coming up here on EA Sports as we come to you from Cincinnati, Ohio, for today's game. Game on each sideline today, and they could be the difference makers.
You know, these tight ends, they can do it all. Tremendous blockers for the running game.
The Texans
got the speed to go down the field, and they got feet, Jim. You know, those quick feet, so even when they run those short routes, if there's man-to-man coverage, they're quick enough and shifty enough to still get away from the defender.
The Texans line up, split backfield from the shotgun. Intercepted by Reggie Nelson. They bring him to the turf.
Game to dig an early hole, but that's what's happened here with the early interception throw.
Yeah, good job on the defense, but I'll tell you, you got to make sure as a quarterback when you throw an interception early in the game that you don't let it get into your head and give self-doubt. Stay positive, go out there, be aggressive, and play that way.
So the Bengals come out in a two-tiny set.
And see what you're doing. No, and just do it. Oh, my God. And just go.
First down at the 39. Going for the home run. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown. And with that touchdown, they grab the lead here early in the first.
Boy, it's always nice to jump out to lead the football game. It just takes pressure off.
Oh, you wonder why?
And
because
what it does, it puts the pressure on the other team. A good spot after scoring that touchdown.
Oh no. No, sir. I'm just drinking it though.
Takes it from the two.
I know.
And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Texans offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So if you made that mistake, let
all
go,
I run.
Go out there, be
no,
aggressive.
It's not. It's just,
see if you
can it's just rude. Rude.
Look out
for
chance to play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Wraps up the quarterback.
I'm not
the
sure if this is kind of blocking.
Making a statement early with a sack.
Yeah, you always want to hit the quarterback early. Get some self-doubt in the quarterback, but also give the offensive lineman some self-doubt. They're like, man, this might be a long day, and I think it will be.
Quarters formation here for the defense. Boyer standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. And Arian Foster has the catch. Denard's in on the tackle. Talking about the offense now. A reliable presence at wide receiver, the sure-handed Nate Washington.
Yeah, what a career he has had. Came out of nowhere, out of Tiffin, like you said, and he's just been a solid receiver. No matter what position you put him in, he could just get it done.
Screen. Blue with the grab. So this offense fails to move the chains here on third down, and that's an early win for this defensive team.
Yeah, it was. Good job by the defense. I like what they did. Now can the offense come on the field and get involved and make something happen and get some emotion on that sideline for that football team?
Jones going to look for space now. Thompson's there to take him down. And a run back of about 12.
The Bengals offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
First down at the 44. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands. That's his first reception today. Coming to the line at the 32. The Bengals come out. Two tight ends on the field.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Dark.
He'll throw it over the middle. Let's talk about the starters on offense. He was the first running back taken in the 2013 draft out of the University of North Carolina, Giovanni Bernard.
Everybody's looking for a running back like Bernard, a guy that can come in and run the draws, catch the screens, and do the little things to make big plays. And what a great year he had as a rookie in the NFL.
They come to the line of scrimmage. First down.
What? It takes so long.
First down at the 18. Almost intercepted.
Right, what the heck?
A player to watch on this Houston defense is cornerback Jonathan Joseph.
Jonathan Joseph loves to play man-to-man coverage, and he's not afraid to take a chance. So if the opportunity is there, he'll get the interception for the defense.
Dalton from the shotgun. Two hands on the football and has the catch.
The Bengals had a nice play designed that time and pulled the defense, and they get the pass completion for a nice pickup.
Now inside the 10 and at the 9. The Bengals come to the line, and they put their receivers in a bunch formation. They'll go ground.
I got one more for you, Jamie. Respect, bitch. I just said one more. What the heck? That's weird. Bro, stop.
First and goal.
I need to throw it.
Dalton's running away from the pressure.
Thank you for coming.
Needs to get rid of it.
I'm going to do really good ball.
Dalton's athletic enough to get out of the pocket. That's a really good job by him. But you have to give the defense a lot of credit. They shut down all the receivers.
Second and goal. Force it across for the touchdown.
Nice job on the front of the offensive line. They get a good push. Easy for the quarterback to run the sneak and get the touchdown score.
Add the extra point. The kick is good. The Texans ready to take that football down the field.
Can you sit down?
He'll have a chance to take off.
Oh, come on, bro. Come on. Just sit, bro. Oh.
The Texans' offense failed to muster a single first down the last time they had it. Let's see if their offense this time can create a few sparks.
Well, you know the coaches were upset at them when they went to the sideline, so the sense of urgency is there. You should be fired up, and I expect a better drive this time.
Press coverage all the way.
Go, go, go.
Now he's going to change the play. And look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
First down at the 32. Climbs the ladder, and he has it. That's his first reception today. At the 45-yard line. They'll go shotgun here. As you look at this defense, they have a 6'7 defensive end, Michael Johnson, who's in on a lot of plays.
Yeah, he is in a lot of plays. So athletic, even though he's 6'7", very flexible, fast, everything you want in a defensive end.
The Texans will take the snap from the 45. Underneath, but can't find the mark that time as the pass goes incomplete. Third and 10 coming up. The Texans need to get to the 35 to pick up a first. The Texans will take the snap from the 45. Intercepted by Reggie Nelson.
Make the adjustments.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled.
It wasn't
being in position.
I had
a
position,
flat play. You have a chance to make a play. That time they did, they got the interception.
Loss of 5 on the play.
Because he was so high up. That's why I put him in effect. Because I knew he was going to play that.
They bring in the extra tight end. First down at the 24.
Uh-oh.
Secures it with two hands. The Bengals still driving as the second quarter gets underway. The pass play picks up only 2. So now it's second down and 8 following the completion.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Jones is going to pull in the bullet pass.
I thought that, so. I don't need to be mad.
First down all the way. That was a big gainer. Now it's time to pack it up. Dalton will take it from the gun. Dalton's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under. Sanu with the catch. Bill Clark Eagles are looking good so far, Phil, and a lot of that has to do with the passing game. Dalton's been in rhythm so far today.
He has been in rhythm. He is hot. Some days, Jim, when you warm up, you know you have it, and that's what happened with this guy today. When he was warming up, he had it, and he has it in the game.
Dalton's going to take it from the gun. Dalton over to Eifert. Mark him down for another reception.
You need balance in the NFL. That's what it's all about. Why do you want balance? To keep the defense guessing what's coming next. That play call on first down, throw. A nice throw and catch just short of the first down.
Dalton's now completed 4 in a row.
Thank you.
Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
Jim, the defense gives up the first down that time inside the red zone, but there's only so many things the offense can do. Let's see if they can hold him.
Dalton's completion percentage 70% on the day. The Bengals come out in a bunch set.
I'm sorry. All right, you go ahead. Yeah.
Dalton's gonna take the snap from the shotgun.
Oh my God!
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do.
Damn, man.
The coverage is too good. The football falls incomplete.
Second and 10 coming up.
Bro, I'm live streaming, kid.
From the gun, Dalton.
Yes, I am.
Dalton's on the move.
Watch his diet. I was about to say.
Third down now.
If I would have had that, I would have gotten the century.
Last play before the 2-minute warning.
Yeah, that's not getting hated.
Andy Dalton in the shotgun formation.
Spit catch.
The blowout continues. Another touchdown. Nice throw by the quarterback.
Hold it in the scuffle, Jaden. Hold it in the scuffle.
Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football.
Hello?
Put it right in there for the touchdown.
I'm asking a question. Are we doing the stunt board or not? Dang. Answer my question. Answer my question. Are we doing the stunt board or not?
The return at the 20-yard line. We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half.
You don't forget it. Jeez, I'm asking the question, and you're not going to answer my question like that.
Back in shotgun formation. Reaches out and snatches it.
I'm running man coverage.
That's his first reception today.
So far, wonderful execution this drive. When you get a chance to get out of bounds, here the offensive player got the yardage, had a chance, gets out of the bounds, stops the clock. Good job by the offense.
So they complete one, and still it's second down. The Bengals sat at the line. Dime package. Hoyer's got it in the gun. Reception by Foster picks up about 5.
That dude's neck is
on. What's the old expression? Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Jim. And also gives them a chance for 3 more downs.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
Where you going?
He's got the sack.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
Hoyer standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Should have had it.
You got to be smart on the defensive side now here, third long. Be a little careful. Maybe give up a short pass or a short run. And if they throw it short, make sure you come up and make the tackle.
The Bengals go with the dime formation here on defense.
Wipes
up the quarterback. Nearing the half, and it's hard to know what this team will focus on during the break. That's another big play by the defense, giving the team a chance to increase the lead.
Well, good job by the defense. Another nice stop. Well, let's talk about the team that's getting blown out here. At halftime, they don't have enough time to go over all that's been wrong so far with their football team. Just focus on this. Play hard and hustle. Very lucky that time and that punt return.
All right, guys, I'm up one nothing in this game, in this series. I'm up 1-0. Give me Saints. Come on, baby. Give me Saints. Alright, there we go. Want me to join yours? Okay. And why did we do it at the same time? What the heck? Are you ready? Uh-oh. The Colts are dangerous. Let's go. What's it? And the Chiefs? Like, why? Well, then, can I re-spend then, since... Oh, no, they don't have to. I'll re-spend. Oh, wait.
Panthers, Chiefs, coming up on EA Sports, Kansas City, Missouri.
We got a crossover conference game about to kick off here. Any thoughts before kickoff, Phil? Well, these two teams don't know each other very well. So when you don't know the other team real well, you know what happens? You get surprised. A lot of big plays. This will be fun to watch.
This game is underway. Able to move past the 20 and... brought down at the 23. The Chiefs will come out in the dime. The Panthers take it from the 23.
Let's go.
The recovery is made by the defense. Touchdown.
Good, yeah.
What a deflating play for the offense. The defense picks up the fumble. Look at the blocks. That makes the offense lose its confidence. They're going to have a hard time coming back out on the field and making it happen.
Webb's got it. And he's met head on right there at the 20. The Panthers had their last drive in with them coughing up the football. And before coming out for this possession, I'm sure there were a few words exchanged on the sideline just to remind these guys you can't do that again.
No, absolutely. Look, there's a lot of things you can put up with an offense in the NFL. You can put up penalties. You can even understand interceptions because so many variables go into that interception. But fumbling the football, that is the worst one of all.
Let's see if they can keep a tight grip on it as this drive gets started.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Almost intercepted that time. He is one of the biggest targets you'll find on the outside of the entire league. Kelvin Benjamin by way of Florida State.
Well, he's so big when you meet him, you can't believe he's a wide receiver. Not only is he tall, but he's also thick. And that's what he uses all that to his advantage. He goes down the field and he can just manhandle defensive backs and make catches.
It's third down coming up. Makes the reception.
Jeez.
When you talk about the play action pass game, it's really when you call it. You got to be in a situation where the defense is thinking run, and when they are, do you have the courage, or I should say the smarts, to fake the run and throw the football? Good call that time by the offense.
Handoff to Jonathan Stewart. Gains five. He is one of the best at plugging up the middle of the line. Keep an eye today on Dontari Poe.
No questions about this guy anymore. He got it done in 2014. He's a force. He can do anything you want on the defense. He can stop the run inside, chase you down to the outside, and most of all, he knows how to get to the quarterback. Coming to the line at the 46. Newton's alone in the backfield. We'll send it back to the quarterback out of the gun.
Going, man.
Intercepted. Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
That's going, man. Come on. Come on. Let's get it popping.
First down at the 48.
Yeah.
Davis that time. Kansas City in the offseason went out and picked up wide receiver Jeremy Maclin from the Eagles, and he's quite a dynamic player, Phil.
Yeah, Jim, and they needed him in Kansas City. Wide receivers caught no touchdowns last year for this football team. They need somebody outside who can make some plays. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Second down and 5. Avant makes the catch, and that's a gain of 10.
Smith's job is to sell that play fake, and boy, did he do it that time. It fooled the defense, and they get the completion.
Smith takes it from the gun. Pumps, fakes the throw.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Panthers were moving the football the last time they had it, only to give the football away on the pick. Let's see how they do it this time.
Yeah, you know, that's a tough situation for the offense. You get a little confidence, and you're moving the football, and then the turnover just changes everything. So you've got to find a way to get your confidence going again.
The Chiefs with two extra defensive backs in the dime. First down at the 17. Billy Brown with the catch.
That's a good job by the receiver, running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
That little throw was good for only 3, so it's now second down and 7. The Panthers at the line of scrimmage, split backfield.
I need
it's complete to Kotchery. First down at the 29.
Come on,
hooks
man.
Up with Greg Olson.
I do legit just pull that up.
Second down and 10. And he's thrown to the ground.
You know, outside linebackers, they're everything all in one. They got to be a pass rusher, a pass cover guy, and he got to be able to stop the run. Nice job that time getting the sack.
Newton's ready for the snap, empty backfield. The Panthers lined up. Everybody split out wide. And it's incomplete. They've come out of the blocks fairly sluggishly. And this defense has taken full advantage, Phil.
Yeah, the offense having a tough time. They did not have a good series that time. And the defense, you're right, took advantage of a sluggish offense and got off the field.
Thomas got it on the return.
That was a drive.
16. And welcome back as we're about to get underway here in this one.
Quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Okay. Alex Smith looking long, but it's
incomplete.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion. Jim, in a situation like this, you just got to be smart. It's third and long. You're winning the football game. Don't take any chances. Don't turn it over. If you punt it, that might be a good thing.
What am I doing with this draw?
Failing to connect there. Third down.
What the heck?
Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. He brings it in.
Get off him.
Coleman's the one who brings him to the ground. Alex Smith will deceive you with his great ability to run. And that time, it was all about scrambling and then finding the open man down the field.
I guess you'd say this about Alex Smith, Jim. He is sneaky fast. When he gets outside the pocket, defenders cannot catch him. And a nice throw on the run.
This play set up by the long gainer.
Here we are early in the second, and we already got a lead that just got increased. I give the offense credit, but somewhere along the line, the defense of the opponents has to step up and just be tougher.
Whitaker on the return. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Panthers heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative, get the defense off guard, make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
And
it's out of bounds, incomplete.
Well, every play is not going to be a masterpiece. This time the quarterback broke out of the pocket. He doesn't find anything he likes, so he makes a good, quick decision, gets rid of the football.
The Chiefs come out in a dime package. The Panthers take it from the 23. As Olsen. That's his fourth catch of the day.
What we're seeing so many times now in this league is the tight ends are getting so good that they have to condense the pass coverage to make sure they stop them, and it's opening up the wide receivers to have a better chance to catch the football. Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
The ball is caught by Kelvin Benjamin. And they get the sack.
Good quarterbacks become great cornerbacks when you have a defense that can sack the quarterback without blitzing. Good job by the defense.
If you guys are wondering why I'm not talking, it's because I'm low-key kind of concentrating. Kind of hard.
The Panthers have it at the 24.
I look
everybody open. What a hit. And the ball falls incomplete.
Well, every coordinator in the NFL has a box over there somewhere in that play sheet for third and long. But he wants to try to pick the play up for the first down with a throw down the field. It could be seams, double moves. But they have four or five of those types of plays to pick up third and long situations.
They motion the receiver around to the other side.
What the? Wait. Why'd you stop?
The Panthers take it from the 23.
Oh, give me that.
Contreras got the catch and the first. Play number six coming up on this drive.
That's not the week, but remember this.
Always try to save the timeout or timeouts when you can. And one way to do it is go to the hurry up offense. Good job.
Newton's
tackled down at the 50.
Cam Newton, how about the Outlaws? This is not bad. I mean, it's not even Mike Vick out there. I mean, maybe. Still. He is fucking man.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Come on, man.
Got it. On a pass, has some heat on it. This will be the eighth play of this drive. They first and 10. Jonathan Stewart with the football. Stewart's met after a gain of three, about to snap it for the ninth play of the drive. Stewart's going to take the handoff now. And he's tackled down after picking up the first. The Panthers are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
Take your three and be done with it, bro.
The long drive continues.
Hope this works.
The Chiefs' defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. From the gun, Newton.
Jeez, that
was. Pass hits the ground and goes incomplete on the short throw.
That was looking insane.
Offense heading to the line for the 11th play of the drive. Newton in shotgun formation. Kotchery with the catch.
Well, that was a nice job by the offense. It just puts them in a better position. Nice little throw and catch. Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the play off. Don't use the timeout here. Good clock management. Snap that football.
Six-yard field goal attempt coming up. There's a flag right there.
No. Oh, let's go. Go for it. I'm going for it.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. The Panthers are at the line of scrimmage with their backfield loaded up. And the target, Ted Ginn.
First down by the offense inside the red zone. Can the defense show them something different here and keep them from scoring a touchdown?
That's so weak.
This is the 14th play of this series. First down here after the completion. Handoff to Jonathan Stewart. Houston's all over that offense and brings him down.
Managing that clock, such a big deal in the NFL. That's why they're hurrying up. Don't use that timeout.
Where are you going?
Maybe give you a chance to win the game.
The Panthers call a timeout here. They have zero timeouts remaining. Mounting a serious drive. One more snap, and we'll head to halftime. Third and goal from the 8. Intercepted! Tackle's made. We've reached halftime, and we'll be sending it back to our studio and Larry Ridley as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports. The second half is officially underway. Davis going to run this one out. The Chiefs come out to open up the second half, and they were hitting on all cylinders in the first half, Phil.
Yeah, be smart here in the second half, Jim. When you start out, just find out what the defense is thinking, and once you get a feeling about what they're going to do, then you start taking some chances.
The Panthers with a nickel look here on defense. First down at the 20. Charles is tackled right at the 20.
Oh, yeah, and guys, by the way, I forgot to tell you, we have to use the playbook that with the team. I forgot to tell you that. So hopefully, y'all stood to watch this part. If y'all are wondering why we're not changing playbooks, that's why.
The Panthers at the line. Dime package.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Wilson's got it, and a first. That's his first reception today.
That time the quarterback throws the drag route. It doesn't get a first down, but still, it's a good decision by him. The throw was right on target, and it picked up solid yards.
Alex Smith's going to take it from the shotgun. Jamal Charles has the catch. Another third down conversion. The offense continues to come through in the clutch.
That's a nice play that time by the offense, getting the first down. They're up here in the second half, and they're moving the football. That's a great feeling.
First down here. The Panthers go with the dime formation here on defense. The give. Fights through contact. Gets about 9 on the play.
Well, we don't see this too often. This is a speed back, but a good job that time just running right through the tackle and breaking it.
Second and short following the run. They better hurry to get the snap. Again, they'll lean on him.
I double juke too fast.
He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Charles is a very smart punter. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. The Panthers lined up in the nickel.
What a fighting idea.
Gets it again.
Oh, gosh.
Charles takes the hit and is brought down.
I'm not even mad. I'm just mad about how my dude is
able to build up that power that he has as a running back. But there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
That last running play was good for only a yard, so it's second down and 9. Play clock's running down. Jamal Charles carries the football. And he is brought down at the 45-yard line.
Charles is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Back down to the half. I just said the half.
It's been all about the defenses today as we welcome you back to the action. Third and 6 coming up.
Jim, look at that. The defensive line all shifting down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
The final quarter begins with this snap. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Johnson's able to read that play and make the hit.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense at time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Coming to the line at the 36-yard line. They need to get the playoff. Smith's going to take it from the gun. The hit knocks the ball
third long. I just say this. Be very careful on the offensive side.
This has been a long drive so far. The Chiefs get set at the line, needing to get to the 22 for a first. The Chiefs snap it at the 36. Makes the catch in open space.
And steps out.
The best way to keep the other offense on the sidelines is just keep marching down the field and picking up those first downs. What a good job by the offense.
Smith's completion percentage, 60% on the day.
Ken, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
And it's knocked down.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. You make a quick break on the football. Hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
This will be the offense's 12th play of the drive.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Smith's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Throw it to the outside. They've got the hookup.
The offense is so close right here. They just need to show a little power and punch this in the end zone and get that touchdown.
What a drive this has been. The Chiefs lined up. Bunch formation. Smith's back in shotgun formation. And it's swatted away.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
The offense back out on the field here for this fourth and short play. Ready to make the stop on the goal line. Loading up that defensive front.
The Chiefs here in the second half, they're winning the football game. I don't understand why you would go for it on fourth down. They go for it, and it doesn't work.
The Panthers offense now will try to sustain a drive after giving the ball away just a few minutes ago before their defense came up with a play to return the pigskin.
Man, they should thank the defense, bailing them out of trouble getting that turnover. You're right, they're just giving the football away, not being conscious of holding it the right way. It's just been sloppy play.
Smith's there that time for the tackle. Second down, tough field position here. The Chiefs will come out in the dime. Two minutes remaining in the game. Second down, late in the fourth quarter. Cam Newton will take the snap out of the gun, out of the shotgun. And here's the throw. Cam Newton throws it. No one's going to get him now. The 40, the 30, the 20, the 10. Going to take it home for the touchdown.
Boy,
the defense is going to be upset after this long touchdown throw by the quarterback and receiver. They made a mistake out of position. And the offense took advantage of it, and they get the long throw for a touchdown out of it.
That's game.
The Chiefs are anxious to return the kickoff.
Oh, my God. I forgot I was going to be there.
And Davis is running this one out. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Chiefs taking the field again on offense. They paid the price for an aggressive decision on their last possession. Passing up on the field goal attempt and going for it on fourth down, then coming up short.
Yeah, look, no second guessing for me on that. I'll just say this. I'll give the defense a lot of credit. They were there. They were ready for the situation. They made the play, and that's why the offense came away with no points.
How do you think the offense is feeling right now after that coach's decision?
Well, shoot, they're disappointed. The coach believed in them. You know that all the coach is showing faith? Well, he showed faith, and they let him down.
First down at the 23. Charles out to the right. That's a gain of six.
Well, when you can run as fast as he can, every once in a while they put those arms around you, that's not going to be enough. Good job of breaking that tackle.
Smith will have it in the pistol. The Chiefs have it at the 29. It's wide open.
Come here, Ankles.
He's
ankles.
In the clear.
That's done.
The 30, the 20, the 10. Yeah. Keeps his legs moving.
Hey, I love situations like this. This is when I was at my best, getting in the huddle and telling everybody all the things.
Put two hands on the football. Don't anybody jump off sides. Don't take any chances. And most of all, stay in bounds. The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Thompson's there to make the stop.
Well, this is not a surprise, Jim. This is what you do. You run the football, you play the clock. This is called managing the game, and it's all up to the head coach getting this done.
Second and goal from the six. Fullback takes the handle.
Dang it, Williams.
You are a quarterback. Oh, you like to put up points. But when you got a win in a low-scoring game, how did it feel?
Oh, guys, I'm up two.
Because when you're the quarterback of the NFL team, it's just like being the head coach. When it's over, everybody wants to know what you
did. Did you win or did you lose?
Well, today we won a low-scoring one, but it still felt great.
Are you here?
For Phil Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.
I'm going to get in water, Jays. I'll be back. I'll be back, y'all. Hold up. Got the Bears. Hello. Patriots got some nice stuff in it. Wait.
It's the NFL on EA Sports.
The Dolphins
two
have
AFC
like,
East
the
teams
have like,
about
like,
to collide as we join
over,
you
like,
from Shetland Stadium. Two incredibly dangerous tight ends getting ready to create problems for the opposing defenses in this matchup, Phil.
Man, when you're a quarterback, there is nothing like having a good tight end. Because, you know why? Because he's close to you. So, it doesn't take great skill to throw the ball 5 or 6 yards from where you're at to a tight end who could catch it nowadays. And not only catch the ball, gets about 10 or 15 extra yards running with it.
Look at this, bro. Look at this. Oh, my gosh. It's about to be good. that. It might not be that much better.
Tannehill's lined up. Two tight ends set. First down at the 21. Collins is going to make the tackle. And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
What's wrong?
But also, solid job by the running back picking up some good yards.
Yo, chill. Oh, my man's trying to run.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
The Dolphins now move the chains.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity. Right on target.
Yo, what the hell is this?
Coming to the line at the 48.
Yo, what the hell is this?
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Tannehill's got it in the gun. Over to Cameron. The Dolphins get a first down.
I know.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches. One of these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
Like that combine.
Coming to the line at the 33.
And Shazier.
The Dolphins come to the line with a bunch set. Now first and 10. He will not get away. He's taken down for the sack.
You're talking about a bonus. When you get a defensive tackle that can get in the backfield and sack the quarterback, that is something special. Great job that time by the big D tackle.
Why'd you say problem? Why'd you say his name? A defensive
ball at the 47. He'll stand back beyond the center in the gun. Balls it in.
That's a nice throw that time by the quarterback to the outside. He knows against his cover three where the weakness is at the sidelines. He took advantage of it with the good throw.
They come to the line and it's first down. Here's the first snap after the big play. Midway through the first. Slashes to the left side. The running back to keep an eye on today is Lamar Miller.
Lamar Miller. Kind of slick, knows how to swim through those holes and get those extra yards. When he's healthy, he's been very productive.
It's an empty backfield for Tannehill this time. Second and 9. Locked in on the breaks the plane, and he's got the touchdown. That's a big way to get the momentum in your favor with that touchdown, Phil.
Yeah, nothing like it. Midway through the first quarter, you're on top of the other team, and you just feel like, hey, we got things under control, and you're putting pressure on the opposition to go out there and try to make something happen.
The point after try is in the books. The Patriots prepared to return the kick. Martin's got a chance to return this one. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line.
Oh, my gosh. What the? No way. Yes. Oh, my gosh. I didn't know how to get out of here. And this is deep. I run in notes, so.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
And incomplete. Didn't get his feet down.
He
He is one of the biggest running backs in the league, LeGarrette Blount.
And he runs like it. I mean, that's the perfect name for him, Blount, because he just goes in there and runs into a pile. Next thing you know, it's second and six because he can gain 4 yards no matter how you block on the offensive line.
Running back in motion here. Second and 10. He pulls it down somehow.
I don't like playing like that.
Nice catch by the Grunt. That's what you want to call it. It says it all about it. When you say the word Grunt, you think of somebody who's big and strong, and that's him.
Like, right there.
After the long game, let's see what they do here. And he's taken down.
Outside linebackers in the NFL, they are such tremendous athletes. They can do everything. How about that play that time? Good move, good speed, gets to the quarterback and gets a sack.
The Patriots are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. The Patriots from the 37. Weaving it down the field, but it's incomplete.
Yo, the fact that I did pick that off is insane.
For this defense, a very good corner in Brent Grimes.
Brent Grimes, he might be small, but he is feisty, he is tough, he is quick, and he can cover guys on the outside. You cannot get enough players on your football team like Brent Grimes.
The Patriots from the 37. Going deep.
Watch this.
And they can't connect. They've come out of the blocks barely sluggishly. And this defense has taken full advantage, Phil.
Yeah, the offense having a tough time. They did not have a good series that time. And the defense, you're right, took advantage of a sluggish offense and got off the field.
Landry is going to take this one from the 10. Taken down at the 21. That return's good for about 12.
The Dolphins offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance. So
well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for him. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out. They got it done.
Tannehill's got two tight ends on the field for this snap.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
First down at the 21. Tannehill's going to take off with it. He caught it on his way. The 10 and in for the touchdown. I hope you have your blowout playbook, Phil, because this game is so one-sided as the first quarter is drawing near a finish.
Oh, shoot, you know me. I'm very limited. I only have one playbook, and that's all out. But, hey, that describes what we're seeing here so far. The offense, the whole football team, they've been sharp, and they're on their way to a blowout.
The Dolphins getting ready for the kickoff.
My boy, I'm like, he just
Martin's got a chance
just
for a return.
As I go.
Around the 33-yard line.
I'd be so good at making it easy.
The Patriots at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. He climbs the ladder and has it.
One of the better talented tight ends in the NFL. He makes that catch just right in stride and gets a nice catch.
It's first down as they head to the line.
What the fuck?
The Patriots still possess the football as we begin the second quarter. First down here.
Oh, shit. How'd you look? He just wasted the yard around there.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. And he knocks the ball out of his hands.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
Breaking huddle coming to the line at the 42. The Dolphins with two extra defensive backs in the dime.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing play here.
Brady to Amendola.
I know it looks easy, but it's not. But a nice throw on the slant route. Slant route means you're slanting towards the inside. Good throw and catch.
Brady's all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Playing press coverage to the outside. The Patriots have it at the 29. Tom Brady makes the catch. Touchdown. How important was that touchdown, Phil, after that first quarter went every which way against them?
It was very important. And listen, you said it. Not that everything was going against them. They were just getting dominated. And the coaches lose confidence. They don't know what to call for the offense or the defense. You get that quick score like that, you are right back in the game.
Steven Gostkowski's readying his team for the kickoff. Landry's got it on the return. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Dolphins offense ready to continue its recent run here as they've scored the last two times they've had it, Phil.
Well, let's look at it from the defensive side. You know, what do you think they're thinking? Oh, my gosh, what's coming next? Because everything the offense has tried so far has worked.
First down at the 28.
Oh my gosh, that is nice.
First down, offense readying for the snap. Tannehill's got no one behind him, just a quarterback waiting for the snap.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
It's caught by Landry, and that's a gain of 9. That's reception number 2 for him. The Dolphins are up right now, and credit goes to the quarterback here, partner. Tannehill's on fire.
It's an awesome feeling as a quarterback to be in rhythm, to get people open and have time to throw the football down the field. That's why they're winning, Jim. You said it right. The quarterback is hot.
Takes it from the gun. The ball lands in the hands of Landry.
When you run that drag route across the field, it is not as easy as it looks. You're running fast. You have to catch the football right in stride, and you cannot see what's in front of you.
Tannehill's alone in the backfield. The Dolphins have it at the 39. Lamar Miller has the catch.
Snapping
the football from the 28. They're back in the line after that catch for a first down. Tannehill from the gun. Looking to go deep. Devin McCourty gets the theft.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception. Good job by the defensive line, shifting all down inside. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
Brady able to find Julian Edelman. Second down after that pass play.
I would pop like a flat tip.
Halftime is coming up. But first, we reach the 2-minute warning.
And that play is easy to stop, but it's madness.
The Dolphins come out in a dime package. Brady from the gun.
Everything's on point.
And with no options, he goes ahead and throws it away.
On 2K and on can, God. Remember that. I'm learning so much.
After the incompletion, third and four coming up. Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side. Gaines, 19. That's reception number four for him. Here's a look now at a tight end who has been heavily featured in the passing game so far, partner.
Yeah, he has been featured. And look, it's such a tough job for the linebackers today. Now they expect them to cover tight ends, to run like wide receivers. Then they say, oh, no, when it's not a pass.
I swear to God. Thank you, bro. Hey, get up. Get up.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Dolphins will try to put a little drive together and not give the football away, Phil, as each team seems to like one treat it like it's a hot potato.
Well, sometimes it is a hot potato. Did you know back in 1985, Jim, I set a record for fumbles in a football season? It wasn't easy to do, but I accomplished it. It was a lot of hard work, and I got it done.
First down at the 20.
I'm so confused right now.
And now Tannehill's going to take off. The Dolphins now move the chains.
Tannehill just able to take advantage of the defense this time. They lose their assignments. They force him out of the pocket, and he's on the run. Nice job of finding the guy down the field to make it the throw. Well, we got a close game here right before half. Good job by the offense deciding to go with the hurry-up offense. What you need here, as many plays as you can get and use up as little time as possible.
Look at that play, yeah.
Second down coming up with about a minute to go before the intermission. The Dolphins all bunched up here as they get set at the line. From the gun, Tannehill. Got hit on release.
Well,
you're the offensive coordinator here in a third long situation, and you're winning the close game. You like to pick this up, but also you got to make sure you call a play that doesn't put the offense at too much risk. Tough call coming up here for the coordinator.
Coming to the line at the 45. The Dolphins need to get to the 35 to pick up a first.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him
Hanson. It's going
to be making the stop.
The Dolphins on their offensive play sheet. They don't have many plays for third and long situations, but that is a really nice job that time by the offense, the quarterback. They pick up the first down. That'll get you going.
From inside the red zone.
Is the goalkeeper. Once you learn how to play it, dude, like,
that long game sets them up here on this play. It's Miller. Ball is out.
What the?
Miami is in for the score. Touchdown. What a fine start to this game. Here we are late in the second quarter. They put up another touchdown, Phil.
Well, they got a nice lead, and they like to take this in at halftime. And if you're the coach of the team leading at halftime, you know what you tell your players? Hey, guys, good job. Let's keep that going. You pat them on the rear and tell them how good they are because, hey, this has been a clinic so far in the first half.
And Amendola's got it.
What's up, bro? What's up, bro?
Return's good for about 24. The Patriots offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
This is the total lockdown. This is total lockdown.
We've got a big lane. Second and two coming up. This will be the last play before halftime. Yeah. The Patriots from the 32. Going for the deep ball. And Jones nearly picking it off. We've reached the intermission. And Sue will be sending you to Larry Ridley, who's going to break down all
the first half highlights as we send it to Orlando in a moment. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. With this kick, the second half is underway. Amendola is going to start his return. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30.
I'm going to need that ball.
Center.
Come on, man.
The Patriots get a first down.
This is so trash, man.
Well, go look at the scoreboard, see which tells you you're down by a couple scores. Just concentrate on every single play and try to get another first down.
Setting up now at the 45. First down here after the completion. Brady is in the shotgun. He's got the catch. And he's on the sidelines out of bounds.
The Patriots coaching staff has done a good job of mixing things up today on first down. The pass catches the defense off guard. They pick up solid yards. Now it's second and short. Now he's going to change the play. And look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
Second down and one. Looking long. What a catch. Sixth catch today so far. Let's go now to Danielle Bellini, who has an injury update.
Guys, I just spoke with a Patriots official. The medical staff is just saying it's a lower body injury and that he's cleared to return. Back to you.
When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Okay. Let's see if he can do it.
I'm not sure.
Coach did at halftime there, Phil, threw the clipboard against the wall or did something. But this team has responded, coming right out and scoring touchdown early in the third quarter.
I'm glad he did it
because it's made this game more exciting and closer, and I can't wait to see what
happens. I'm trying to find offense.
The Dolphins are back deep, waiting for the kick.
The
Dolphins offense takes the field.
Because I have the right to. I'm kicking your ass.
From the first half because they have
I have the right to.
This point, partner.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room. At
because you're aggressive catch it like under the boot.
That's right. Of course, you got to realize the defense.
Oh, yes, I don't want no amateur to talk to me.
And keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
Yeah, that's how I fucking.
The Dolphins
I don't know.
At the 24.
It didn't work though. That's all I know. Come
right
here.
Somebody
got patched though.
People talk about time of possession. Sometimes it's overblown, but in a situation like this, where you're winning a close game in the second half, you want to control the tempo, control the clock, keep getting those first downs. Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Miller's taking the handoff.
Yeah.
Nice job that time by the offense getting the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm because you got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
Here, oh my, they have no iPhone. What is this foolishness, bro? They have no iPhone.
First down here after the run.
They have no iPhone.
Tannehill standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Intercepted.
Come on, Brooks.
That brings the play to an end.
Got to stay aggressive on the defensive side. That time the defense did. Even though the offense was going in to score, they finally come up with a big play, and they get the interception inside their own 20-yard line.
Good play, though. No, that's not what I want to do, but it's cool. Just got a couple fucking off. What'd you say?
The Dolphins defense now going, loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. First down at the 39.
Get a fucking shit,
pass is intercepted.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, yeah, and they made the interception.
The Dolphins just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold on to football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? The coaches, look, you make mistakes on the field, they're going to be forgiving to a point, but you got to be smart.
Are you ready, Jalen? The big down 146?
Get the job done.
Are you want to lag? Are you want to lag that? Are you want my blitz, basically?
For this play, they'll go with
don't you have that
tight ends
on
first and 10. Miller's met at the 30.
And with your
I gotta give this running back a lot of credit. How
and
about that?
It?
He fumbled earlier in the game, but now he is running free, just all out and getting those extra yards after the hit.
So we can
the
lag
Dolphins
it.
Will take the snap
actually,
from the 30.
It's
now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush.
People a lot to block it, so.
The Dolphins offense has switched sides now and has the football as we begin the fourth quarter.
A line. I hope you realize a no blue. I'll let you say the book. I'm the hook.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. And methodically, he just throws it away.
Well, you got to give the defense a lot of credit that time. As the quarterback broke the pocket, the defensive backs did a good job staying with the receivers. Nobody's open. Quarterback has no opportunity except to throw the football away.
Third and 7. Handoff
made. Come here, boy. Anchors.
He's brought down at the 20-yard line.
This play right here is a glitch. This play is a glitch. Watch. If I run this right here, kinda. I don't
know.
I see somebody run this. It looked insanely good. I don't know. No.
Lamar Miller with the carry.
Anytime
you go for a fourth down in the NFL, that's a big play. And when the game is close in the second half, it becomes a huge play. That was a wonderful job by the defense stopping him there on fourth down.
Loss of 4 on the play. The Patriots have been in a fight today. The scores 21-14. First down at the 24.
And you have one free play and you're down the roof. I can hear you talking. My controller
second down here.
Really just lag.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. The Dolphins sat at the line. Dime package.
There it is.
Quarterback. He's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
This play will hold up. He's inbounds.
I'm not even going
to say good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and you know you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
This is fucking Gronk. Bro, where's Gronk going? Oh, where's Gronk going?
The play clock's running down.
Come here, Gronk. Hey, Gronk.
And it's hauled in by Edelman.
There has been good pass protection for the quarterback all day long. He has not been sacked much, and he throws it there and gets another completion.
And the series. Uh-huh.
Set up now at the 12-yard line.
I know you are.
First down following the long play.
Brady
is going to take it from the gun. Brady to Amendola.
once as every year is a monitor, it means
second down.
Because a friend of yours, you know, it was a good, good world. But we can't leave it there again. By the way,
snap back to Brady from the gun. Had it for a moment, but the ball
thank
is
you.
Knocked out incomplete.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
The Patriots, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You've got you're down just a few points. Just keep
it
in for the touchdown. That touchdown ties this game as we move into crunch time. Partner, who knows what these final moments have in store for us?
Yeah, we don't know, Jim, but I know this. Keep the pressure on. The defensive coordinators, this team takes the field. Go out there, do something they haven't seen before. Put the pressure on the opponent's offense and see if they can handle that. I don't think they can.
Landry's going to test the coverage this time. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Dolphins found themselves in good position the last time they had the ball, but chose to go for it on fourth down instead of bringing out the field goal unit. And that proved to be costly.
Yeah, they got to remember who they're going against on the defensive side. This defensive coordinator is smart. He knows all these situations, and he guessed right with the offensive coordinator.
Boy, for as well as they drove the ball down the field the last time they had it, only to come up empty on that fourth down stop. How is this offense going to react on this drive?
I don't know. I can tell you from experience, it's demoralizing when you drive the football and you get in scoring territory where it's 3 or 7 and you come away with nothing. It's tough. So you got to pick yourself up and make it happen.
Second down after the incompletion. Tie game here in the late going, and the defense needs to make a stop. They cannot give up the big play right now.
I think it's important for the defense. Anytime it's a third long situation for the offense to know where those first down markers are, give a little ground, and make sure you're able to come up and make the tackle short of the first down marker.
And this play is
now looking at third down.
What did I do that? That's good enough.
Time becoming a factor in this game.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
Ryan Tannehill will take it from the gun. Ajaya with the reception. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. The Dolphins take it from the 28.
No way.
The Dolphins turn the ball over on downs.
The Dolphins go for it on fourth down, and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
The Patriots getting set to take over again on offense. They'll be trying to pick it up right where they left off with their last drive that ended in a touchdown.
Yeah, they throw the football well. And I'll tell you, I've been covering this game a long time. There's still nothing pretty than seeing a quarterback drop back, perfect spiral down the field, and watching guys catch it. That was a work of art the last drive.
No, I know they think if it's going to get blocked or not.
That leads us to second down. 2 minutes to go before this one's in the books.
I don't have in the play for you, anyway. I'm going to try to.
This will be second down.
And the skill for you. Yo, chill. I really just ranking it. Wow, you really have nobody open.
Jarring hit that time knocks the ball free.
I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good job by the defensive player.
The Patriots get a first down.
My
gosh, the wide receivers now, it's just, it's incredible. It's not that we have one. Every team has two or three, and some have four. Good job that time by him hauling in that pass. Teams in the NFL spend about 30-40% of their time all week long practicing plays in the red zone. So there's a lot they can do here. Let's see if they come up with something that works.
It's now second down and seven after the 3-yard rush. The Patriots come to the line and they put their receivers in a bunch formation.
Right here, bro. Right here, bro. Right here, bro. Right here, bro. Let's go, man. Let's go, man. Bring that
There's
back.
A call we don't see all that often. An illegal forward pass.
Tap,
yeah, that's
square.
Right. The quarterback that time was past the line of scrimmage. He lost his judgment where he was at on the football field. I can understand why. Trying to avoid so many hits. Didn't realize he crossed the line of scrimmage.
We've got about a minute to go here, and the game is tied.
Everybody focusing on Gronk real quick, bro.
Third and 12.
Backups. Everything is clamped up. Look at his ass. Let's go! You're a field goal racer! You're a field goal racer!
Bring them out right now. Make the play and
come
win
on,
this
man.
Game.
Double tight end formation.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing play here.
Let's go. We come up close.
Coaches have gray hairs for situations like this.
Take it,
fumbles the football and somehow recovers it inside their own 20. Boy, that'll make a head coach scratch his head.
I really don't even know what to call it.
And a real tough spot here on second down. The Patriots go with the dime formation here on defense. Tannehill's gonna take the snap from the shotgun.
And I'm smart.
Makes the catch in the open field.
I'm so smart.
And he's taken down, but not until he picks up the first. The Dolphins, one timeout remaining.
Hey, it was a dot. Just take that dot, bro.
Final 30 seconds, and it's a first down.
Just the take
Dolphins
it out,
come out
just take
in
it
a bunch set.
Let's take it out, bro. Let's take it.
Ryan Tannehill backing off the line, dropping back shotgun.
Just take it, though, bro.
Tannehill's back in shotgun formation.
Choose one. Oh, you picked wrong. You picked wrong.
Is there to
you
catch
picked
a ball
wrong.
That had a lot of heat on it.
I threw for 340. Oh, man.
Tie game right now. We'll go to the hurry up and hold on to the timeout. First down at the 49. Jordan Cameron with the catch. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. The Dolphins are at the line, and they are out of timeouts. It's a two tight end formation.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Has
Cameron. Not early.
And he's tackled. We're going to be headed to overtime as they will not get another playoff in time.
Gosh. Oh man, it's cool. It's fine.
The Patriots prepared to return the kick. Martin steps up for the return, and he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. But the Patriots back onto the field. Of course, the last drive they had it. Looked like they were going to put up some points. Only to watch the football get picked off in opponent's territory.
Smart defensive coach they're going against in this game today. He knows how to put his players in positions to make plays, and he did that last drive, and they came up with the option.
Is that just a great play by the defender?
I'm giving most of the credit to the defender. It's just a good play.
Going to take it the distance. It's a
it's
almost impossible to guard these guys nowadays as they go down the field. These wide receivers, they have feet like ballerinas, and even though you get tight coverage, they're so quick, they can get open and make the catch.
No, I am.
So for Bill Sims and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.
No, only you beat me in Madden because of your team, like an ultimate team. And right here, Gronk, literally, if you go back and watch it, I'm not getting mad, it's just, that's bitches play. How am I making an excuse? How is that an excuse though? You did. If you went aggressive cut to Gronk, you wouldn't have got those first downs. No, you send it, nigga. I'm not mad, kid. Jesus Christ. I'm talking low. That's why I'm not trying to fucking yell so my dad can hear. My dad's trying to sleep. Jeez, to put the man to sleep. My dad wasn't home, that's why. Do it. I mean, that's gonna let me yell that loud. And I'm done. I didn't change it. Look. Let me just check and see. Oh yeah. They gave me the 49ers. Oh my gosh, you have the Vikings. Yeah. And that one game we played, and I said to choose the Vikings, played it, and you knew what you were doing. Yep. Let's go. GG's all around. GG's it. Okay. Yeah, because it said. No. Really? Why is Cash? My dude, Cash might even finna be starting a backup quarterback. Not about to throw dive, bro. Why is Cash at the park? That fullback dive, no. That fullback dive. You don't know nothing about that fullback dive. You don't know nothing about that. Yeah, you don't know nothing about that. Yes, let me go. So let me get into winning position of the series, and I'm going to close it out.
It's the NFL on EA Sports. Kickoff looming, and this NFC West matchup as we join you from Levi's Stadium. What a matchup we have at wide receiver today. Two of the biggest threats in the NFL who love to cause chaos for opposing defenses. How about this matchup?
Yeah, you know, it's interesting. When you have speedy wide receivers, what you have to do, you got to make sure your safeties are smart and talented. Both teams have that because it is easy in this game nowadays to get the football to the wide receiver. They can't get open down the field.
I don't live in the same
time. Screens on the outside, and they're the defense to tackle.
Bro, what the hell? Oh. Surprising.
The 49ers have it at the 29. Marked down at the 34. That's a nice powerful statement as they establish the run at the beginning of this game.
Jim, you're right. I'm going to give the offense a little credit here. Somewhere, I don't know, maybe the defense is going to have to put some weight in their pockets. You got to hang in there and make the tackle.
I like that hit.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. The Seahawks will come out in the dime. Kaepernick takes it from the gun.
Yeah.
Airing it out. And Bolden brings it in. A foot race to the end zone. And he's in for the touchdown. What a play.
Are we really about to do this?
I give all the credit to the wide receiver here. What a route. Fooled the defender. He is wide open. Nice throw by the quarterback for the touchdown.
Really about to do this.
The point after is good.
So, I'm honestly about to do this. Get in position.
Stiff arms to stay on his feet. He's brought down at the 20-yard line. That return's good for about 26.
I'm gonna make a release, so you better watch out. I'm the grammar police. You better watch out.
First down at the 20. Lynch looking for a lane. After running it, it's second down.
You want to do this for me?
Here's the handoff to Marshawn Lynch. I know you love this set of linebackers. Navarro Bowman, one of those right in the middle of the field.
Well, he's a linebacker, Jim, that can play all three downs. Good against the run and fast enough and athletic enough to cover tight ends and wide receivers over the middle.
Cash, why are you spamming? I can hear my background spamming buttons. Dude, okay.
Third down and 8. Looking long. Reed makes the interception. This interception in the first quarter could only add to what is already looking like a dominant performance.
Yeah, it was a good job by the defense, but let's be honest here, Jim. That was a terrible call by the offense, a terrible throw by the quarterback. They took advantage of that and got that pick.
I wasn't even used there, though.
First down at the 45.
Come on, man! I don't care.
Richard Sherman can really play. Hey, he can really talk too. He likes to tell everybody how good he is, and he can back it up. That was a beautiful interception.
The Seahawks are set to take. I was one on one. Yours was. I don't know what that was. Crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back.
Oh, man, Marshall got some speed.
I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took him to the sideline and just gave him heck. That's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You've got to go out there and be much better.
The Seahawks take it from the 38.
Nice.
And it's caught by And Eric Reed brings a halt to that last attempt.
Corner routes not thrown enough in this league anymore. A lot of teams don't do it because it takes a strong arm quarterback to get it done. That was a terrific throw on the field that time.
Lynch is going to secure the handoff.
Yo, that stiff arm. Who gave you the stiff arm?
Well, they call him the beast, Marshawn Lynch. I call him the rope because he loves contact. He knows how to hit
your safety. I don't know.
Make him go backwards. That time he does it, it picks up a first down.
About to eat my glitches up.
First down coming up. That was a big gainer. Powers his way across. Touchdown. And that touchdown, Phil, here late in the first, ties the game.
It gets him out of a little hole.
And, of course, it gives the offense a lot of confidence. And on the defensive side, they have struggled early, but maybe they can start to pick things up.
No, not again. Trust me. I already messed up.
Gets the handle here.
I forgot that my guys are fast. Oh my gosh, I forgot. I forgot this is ready to boot the football down the field. Cause I have David Johnson there, and David Johnson just gets in there with ease.
Got it. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line.
The 49ers offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the
turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah,
it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points. Carlos Hyde has the catch.
The fact that I had two people there was taking really a look weird. At the offensive starters. They were both
Anquan Boldin has been one of the most physical wide receivers in this league for over a decade.
Maybe
he's been physical, he is productive, and I think he has the strongest pair of hands in the NFL when you talk about receivers.
There you go.
Second and six.
Nope, bro, nothing is open, bro. This is cramps.
Space to work.
Yo, why he died like that?
Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line. The Seahawks with two extra defensive backs in the dime. First down at the 39.
Bro, nothing's open. Nothing is open, bro. Where are you going? I have a QB spy there, bro. What are you doing?
Almost intercepted.
Stevie Wonder.
He is a defensive lineman who can dominate a game. Jeez. Michael Bennett.
I've never had lost like from before.
Every single play in the Super Bowl in the 2014 season.
The game.
He was absolutely magnificent. He almost won the game.
Oh, you definitely.
Second down and 10. Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short game.
He's still about to lose. Though.
Kaepernick's got it in the gun.
I'll take that, bro. Thank you, Stevie. What's up, Kevin?
He's brought down. We're back here to start the second quarter. Partner, when you're in a tight defensive game like this, what does an offense have to
do to open
this game up?
Well,
I think what happens sometimes in situations like this, Jim, you know, the offense, they plan for the game and what they're going to do, but they come out there that first series or two, and they go, wow, these guys are better in person than they were on the film. So you've got to adjust physically. I think now that they have adjusted, we'll see if they can make some things happen. The Seahawks will take the snap from the 35. And that'll gain just a few yards. If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work. The Seahawks from the 32.
Get in there, big boy. Get in there, big boy.
Well, everybody talks about the pass in the NFL.
In there, boy.
When it's third and short, you got to man up and be tough and strong. Nice job that time by the offensive line. They let the running back get in there and pick up the first down. They come to the line of scrimmage. First down. Graham's on the right side. Split out wide. Lynch slashes to the left side. Lynch is tackled down at the 15. He's now over 50 yards rushing on the day. All set up now at the 15. Lynch is in the backfield. First down at the 15. They'll stay on the ground on first down. Ball is out. Touchdown, Seahawks. Midway through the second quarter, they put themselves in front
with that touchdown, Phil.
Hey, that touchdown could be a difference maker in this game. You never know. So really well called by the offensive coordinator and executed perfectly by the offensive players.
They call his number, so put down a touchdown and a two-point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. He executed the play perfectly, and he got in the end zone, like you said, and got that 2 points.
I'm guessing he just made a dagger.
Ellington's going to run this one out.
Uh-oh.
And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The 49ers offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Tim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Got a big lane.
Bro, why is that so slow? Minister down. Why you lose, guys? And you set those.
First down all the way. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. The catch is made.
I'm looking back.
Made by Bennett that time.
The key to being a really good route runner and running these drag routes across the field is show some courage. Don't worry about what's in front of you. The quarterback will take care of that.
Okay. There we go. Now this is on the glitchy.
This next play coming from the 47-yard line. We're moving in on the two-minute warning. One more snap first. Bolden's got it on a pass that had some heat. And we've reached the two-minute warning in this one.
I'm doing this legit running.
The 49ers lined up, bunch formation.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, definitely, bro. He's definitely open. Oh, I mean, nobody else is open, so I mean.
The line of scrimmage, the 32-yard line. Second and 10.
Throw that at you. Don't dare you move. I dare you.
Every defense is looking for somebody to hit the quarterback, and the best person to do it is the defensive end.
I'm actually not running
fag.
Good
job that time by him.
Third down after the sack.
And you don't know what fag D is, do you?
The Seahawks come out in a dime package. The 49ers get set at the line. Need to get to the 22 for a first.
Kaepernick, bro. We need to go back on the bench, bro. I'm sorry. This is really bad. Get your ass back on the bench, guys. Get your ass back on the bench.
The coach is going to go for it.
I'm
going to
beg you.
The 49ers come to the line.
If you run the ball, oh my gosh, it'd be pancake. And if you run the ball, my guys won, because I'm not going to beg you.
The 49ers have it at the 44.
I worry about that one.
You
still got
to
just get extended with the first now.
The Niners go for it on fourth and long, and it does not work out.
Well, listen, fourth and long, no matter when you go for it, your chances of making it are not very good. And that time it doesn't work. Good job by the defense being alert and knowing the situation.
From the 22. It's Jermaine Kearse coming down.
I look
with
what
it.
I'm going to do. Get down for you. Because they have like
that
players.
Little throw was good for only three. So it's now second down and seven.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving him hand signals.
Get the feet down, but this will be ruled incomplete.
These NFL receivers are so fast that you just got to get rid of that football and let it go. That time the quarterback waits a little too long, and he underthrows the receiver down the field.
Third and seven. Wilson's going to scramble. Fakes the throw, and he's going to be dropped with a sack.
Oh,
and they're going to be punting after a short series.
Why did we punt fake? I didn't even press the punt fake button in here. I know y'all saw my dude on the stream, right? Like, my dude was good.
John Ryan will be called on to send this one down the field.
I look, you say stream. What the hell?
And that punt is going out of bounds. They are not going to allow them to return it.
Snap
it at the 36. Brings down the quarterback. Call a timeout.
I'm getting the ball back, hopefully. I'm gonna try to get the ball back. I low key literally like pressed the button like three times and he didn't throw it. Quick fingers, bitch.
From the 22.
My controller.
Makes the throw. The ball is fumbled. They recover their own fumble. What a lucky break time. They fumble, but they recover it and maintain possession. NFL teams, the offense, every single day they work with anybody that's going to handle the football. How to hold it. He didn't do a good job that time. That's why he fumbled. Press coverage all the way. The 49ers get set at the line, needing to get to the 46 for a first.
We got him in the envelope.
The 49ers take it from the 23.
Throw that! I'm right there! Throw that! Envelope, like I just said. Envelope.
They're in punting formation.
You have your defense. What are you talking about? Okay, guys, in the stream, finish. I would literally hear Jaden say that he has a defense that he runs in mud, and right now he's complaining.
And a run back of about nine.
You guys can't
run
either.
Seahawks offense comes back onto the field. Let's see if they can move the chains this time, because the last possession was ugly. They weren't out there very long.
Jim, you know how I think in situations like this, I think it's more up to the coach than the players. Call a play that really catches the defense off guard.
I don't care.
So you can get an easy gain and get the momentum on your side and get it rolling. Do the little things right. And doing it right is what this offensive player did that time. Had a chance to get out of bounds, stop the clock, give his offense more chances. Really good job by the offensive player.
Oh my gosh,
a yard or two. He didn't get many yards that time on that run, but he's had a terrific day. When there's an opportunity to get some yards, he's been there to take advantage of it.
That'll do it for the first half. We'll be sending you to Larry Ridley back in our studios as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports.
It said four verse. I was like, no.
The second half is officially underway. Fields the football at the three. And the tackle's made. The offense will start their drive from about the 31. The Seahawks take the field here in the second half, looking to extend their lead in this one, partner.
We don't want Jaden to get the ball back. That's our goal.
Halftime is over. You come out here, you're not sure what the new game plan is going to be, but feel your way into the game. Don't take a chance early and turn the football over.
First down at the 31. Lynch is all over the ball carrier.
49ers defense is so fast and so powerful. That time on the run play, they just overpowered
the
offensive line. They tackled the runner for a loss.
And here we have second down. An extra tight end on the field for this one.
Now he's going to change the play. And look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
wants to go deep.
Yeah, what's up, boy? Get juked out by the white boy. Get juked out by the white boy. Juked out by the white boy.
Makes the hit.
Good job by the offense picking up a first down.
Because
they've
he's
been
super
terrific all day long.
Bro, the fact that my dude literally,
and they are tiring this defense out.
The fact that Russell threw that though, good stuff, Russell.
The offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
First and goal from the five, and that's a 2-yard gain.
If I'm on the defense and the offense is this close to scoring, I'll tell you what I'm doing. I am sending everybody. I am going to gamble that it is a run. If they have the courage to throw it, let them. If they do, of course it'll be a touchdown.
Second and goal from the three.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
The football sits at the three. Halfway through the third quarter, Wilson with the give. Ball is out. By the defense.
Oh, look at the old man.
No one's going to get him now.
Dude, oh, shit.
He's at the 50. Tackles made.
It's plain and simple. If you want to stay in the game, you got to hold on to football. Time, that fumble, that was careless. Keep those hands wrapped around him when the defenders are getting ready to hit you.
The 49ers offense coming back onto the field here, desperately trying to avoid a repeat of their last drive when they had the quick three and out.
I'll tell you what, if they go three and out again, you know what's going to happen? Those defensive players are going to be looking at them as they come off the field. You put this back out there already, so it's important to get a drive, give your defense a little rest.
The 49ers from the 32, toss to the outside. Third down. Playing press coverage to the outside. It's Bush in the backfield.
Uh-oh, box time. It's time for that box. It's time for
Smith's got it on a pass. Had some heat on it.
Okay, everybody is going to watch this video. That's KJ Wright, too. That's not no bum. That's KJ Wright.
From the gun.
Play almost got him in here, and when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back just jump over the top for the touchdown.
Miller's got it, man. He's in for the touchdown. That touchdown, Phil, ties things up as the fourth quarter is approaching, and who knows, this might be headed for overtime when it's all said and done.
Well, I don't know about overtime. The play calls were very good, and the execution by the offensive players, top-notch.
This is cool.
The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. Fields the football at the 8. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30. The Seahawks just gave up some big turnover points. Let's see if they can hold on to the football this time, Phil, because we know how crucial it is. We talked to the coaches about it this week. This was their concern with this team.
Well, if you want to stay on the field, you better quit turning it over, right, Jim? That's what the coaches, look, you make mistakes on the field, they're going to forgive you to a point, but you got to be smart, you got to be efficient, and get the job done.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. The fourth quarter just about to get underway. Man. How do you see this game unfolding, Phil?
You know, listen, these defenses have been so aggressive, and they're just overplaying everything. I think you need to do something like a reverse or catch them off guard, a counterplay, to take advantage of the fact that these defenses are just over-pursuing.
Okay. I pressed the wrong play.
Coming up, second down.
I pressed the wrong play.
Lynch lined up as the single back.
Here's the handoff to Marshawn.
Oh, he's slow.
He is tackled
at
the 44.
I mean, he's tired.
Well, not many yards get there on that play, but it doesn't matter. What a day and what a job this running back has done here.
He looked real good.
The defense looking for one more stop here on third down after that run.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Looks but can't connect on the short throw. Early in the fourth, and another great defensive stop. It's urgency time for these offenses.
It sure is. Let's see which offense can go out there and make a play and not make the mistake. Because these defenses are playing so well, when you try to force the issue in a game like this, a lot of times the offense makes the big mistake to lose the game.
The wide receiver shifting around in motion. The Seahawks turn the ball over on downs. Just a massive play by the defense to get the ball back and put the team in position to take the lead here in the first minutes of the final quarter.
Yeah, but I'm going to look at it from the offensive side. They didn't make it. I like the fact that they went for it on fourth. Now your defense has got to come out there and bail you out and give you one more chance to win.
Miller's tackle right at the 28.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Second and two. Kaepernick with the handoff. And it's Earl Thomas who brought him down that time.
Have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
Colin Kaepernick under center. First down and 10. The running off the toss.
It's delayed.
He's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there is nowhere to go. That's a short game.
There you go. Let Big Daddy set up.
Well, we were at practice on Friday, Jim. This team was working on red zone offense all the time.
I'm just going here. I'm going to go for two. Anyway.
Touchdown. At the most critical time, they found the end zone and taken the lead. It's up to the defense now to hold on to it.
Yeah, that's what they've done. They put the pressure on their defense, go out there and finish this game off. And then, hey, look, you always got to feel good as a defensive player when you take the field with the lead.
This series should be over, but last game, I gave the last game up.
They'll take it at the 20. The Seahawks back out there on offense. Their last drive, they had fourth down. On their own side of midfield, they decided to go for it. Instead of punting the football away, we both were wondering why.
Oh, man, some people just never learn. They keep going for it on fourth down when they're in their own territory, and it always backfires. And what do you expect? Well, I know what you can expect, another loss. You just got to be smart with your decision-making when you're managing a football game. The Seahawks look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Let me adjust, please.
The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
The pass play was good for five. Second and five coming up. Time is running out here in the fourth, and the defense is trying to preserve this win.
That's
a nice job by the offensive coordinator there, being patient here in the fourth quarter. He's not down that much, so he's sticking with the run game and gets a short run that time.
Third down now.
I'm not even getting mad, but I don't know why you just said take your own medicine.
This is a big third down snap.
We're drawing near a close,
and the defense is trying to preserve a victory.
The middle says sneaky.
Third and four. Wilson's on the move.
Oh.
Wilson's unable to find his target that time.
When you're losing and you have the football, you need to make a play on third down. That was
That was just a bad play call, and now it's fourth down. You're going to have to punt.
I am so mad, though. That was the dullest play ever.
They bring back out the offense to go for it.
Like, not even like barely wide open. There was nobody
going for it on fourth.
About to be a walk in the park, Toby. Why is my eye twitching? Jeez.
The Seahawks take it from the 38. Launches it down the field.
Fucking bitch.
Nice catch. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown. A remarkable touchdown pass. It is pressure-packed the circumstance as you're going to find it, partner. Suddenly, this is anybody's ball game.
Absolutely. Boy, to play quarterback like that, to see him play, so much talent. Man, it's got to be fun to have that much talent.
And we might be headed to overtime.
Thank you, Russell, for actually making the throw, man. If Russell would have missed, I would have been mad if Russell would have missed that throw. I would have been like, dang,
he's got a chance to return this one. Gets out past the 30 and brought down at the 35. The 49ers will be trying to make it three successful drives in a row as they retake the field here on offense, partner.
They got a great feeling from the offense so far. In other words, they're confident, they feel good, so you need to keep calling plays. It keeps the offensive players in a positive frame of mind. You do that, hey, I wouldn't be surprised to see him march down here and score again.
Come here, Captain Luke. You saved it.
And now they'll try over again on second down.
We're ready to murder, that's why.
We are tied, and this game has less than a minute to go.
We're ready to murder. That's my fault.
McDonald's there to catch
that's not really
a lot of heat on it. The 49ers call the timeout. They're first.
It might be wrong, but it's going to be like
the 49ers come to the line, fourth quarter, with two timeouts remaining.
My lucky shouldn't have called a time. Oh, I'm so stupid. Oh, that's just my fault. It's late. I'm just wasting my time. So that's just my fault. I'm being dumb. I'm being extremely dumb.
Set up now at the 37. The Seahawks defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants
lurking.
To take advantage of.
I see your pick lurking. I see your pick lurking.
Come on. And the quarterback is tackled by Bruce Irvin.
That's an awesome job by the outside linebacker. Gets a sack on the quarterback. And nowadays, you've got to do it all if you're an outside linebacker. You've got to be tough against the run, cover receivers down the field, and yes. Plays like that get to the quarterback.
The 49ers take it from the 43. Hines tackled right at the 20.
We got a close game here late in the fourth
I'm
quarter.
So sick.
Nobody
I'm losing to this
expecting
gun,
the run. The defense
oh
thinking
gosh,
pass
bro.
All the way, and they give up
it's
a
so
huge
trash.
First down. Well, when you have a tie game and you're down in the red zone, you can do whatever you want. You can pull it with a run here, or you can take a chance and throw the football in the end zone to get a score.
I'm so confused on that play.
The field goal unit now has a chance to give them the lead here late in the fourth.
Not even the night, it lost to you.
And it's good. Almost no time left on the clock. They may have just locked up the win with that kick.
Jim, they get the field goal at that time, and it keeps the momentum on their side. It's positive energy. It makes you feel good. Now we'll see if the defense can carry it on.
What the hell am I doing?
The touchback. The Seahawks offense still has a chance here, Phil. Late in the game, can they make something happen?
Well, it's going to be interesting to see, Jim. I think let's look at it from the defensive side. Know the situation. If they get the ball, they catch a pass, make sure you come up and make the tackle. Don't let them catch and run and get a big play against you.
I'm sure it doesn't get much better than that for a kicker. The game winner at the end.
Nah, they live. That's what they live for, Jim. Yeah, that's what you sit in bed at night and dream about. Kicking the game-winning field goal. Happened here today. What a great moment for him.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance saying so long.
Oh my God, bro. Why did my phone keep dropping? What do I do with this? Do I put it in here? Okay, I'll use all this. Bro, what the heck? This stuff is confusing. Okay, that feels extremely weird. Just send the invite, dang, man. No, because you're so stupid. You sent the invite for the past 3 games. Well, why would you not send it now? Why would I want to switch it up? There's no... Because CK actually uses his brain sometimes. I don't know what you're doing. I got my music playing. Oh yes, the Bengals have, and the Bengals have nothing that you run. The Bengals don't have any type that you run on defense. The keyword is used to, like, what do you use, like, last patch? Like last patch or what? Last patch? Or was it last patch? I can't hear you right now, but I'm on this. Loki might be talking loud. I'm gonna try it. I'm trying to whisper. That stuff hurts my ears. I really don't care. My ears are already hurt.
Saints Bengals coming up on EA Sports, Cincinnati, Ohio, for today's game.
You know, when you get a matchup at running back like the one we have here today, you can just look down on the field from the booth and you can see that breakaway speed and power with your own eyes, and there is a difference out there.
Yeah, I think I was always heard from Bill Walsh. I read it in his book, Trust Your Eyes. So you're right, we look down the field today, and as this thing goes along, you can tell we have two stars at running back, and man, just give them a little bit of hope and they can make it happen.
The Saints from the 22. In the end, it picks up only a yard. Focusing now on this offensive unit, Marcus Colston is always a favorite target.
He is a tremendous target for the quarterback, and I'll tell you this, it doesn't matter if he's covered, he's always open. If you throw it out there and there's tight coverage, he'll find a way to come down with the catch.
Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains.
I love these timing routes. The out route, nice job by the wide receiver. As he's breaking out towards the sideline, that football is right on target. quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
The Saints take it from the 33. Brandon Cooks makes the catch.
Don't see enough of this in the NFL anymore, the out route. Everybody's afraid to throw it. They want all those little safe dink and dunks inside. But that is a nice throw and catch by the quarterback and wide receiver.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Out of the gun. Breeze on the move. Mark Ingram with the reception. This defense today will rely heavily on Ray Malaluga.
Yeah, Ray Malaluga just has such energy on the field, plays all out, smart, knows where to go. Great qualities for a linebacker.
Mark Ingram with the reception. He's into the open.
Yeah,
Reggie
boy,
Nelson makes the
now.
Tackle.
What a nice catch by the receiver. Getting past the yard markers, makes the catch and gets a first down.
Just 25 yards to pay dirt. This play set up by the long gainer. Breeze in shotgun formation. Down the field. What a first series. Touchdown. The lead is theirs now after that trip to the end zone. That gives them some momentum here at the start, Phil.
Yeah, listen, halfway through the first quarter, you score that touchdown. Now you're leading in the game. Boy, that's a great place to be. And also, I know it's early, but you hit on the opposition right away.
Tate will test the coverage. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Saints at the line. Dime package. Dalton standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. And it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit. One of the most dynamic players in the National Football League is wide receiver A.J. Green.
Jim, you're right. He is dynamic. One of the best in the NFL. Tall, fast, and can make every catch. A.J. Green is one of the best.
Bernard out to the right. The tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
First and 10. Here's the handoff, and they'll run it. Running room. And Kenny Vaccaro is in on the tackle.
Bernard's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
Looks like they're in press coverage here.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
A.J. Green with the catch. Set up now at the 39-yard line. The Bengals at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. Tackle made by Browner that time.
Jim, when you see these out routes thrown and caught, it's all about timing and rhythm. The quarterback, he has both. That throw is right on target. Nice throw and catch.
The Bengals will take the snap from the 25. And it's knocked down. This defense features one of the best safeties in the game in Jarius Byrd.
Jarius Byrd is one of those safeties that you love, Jim. A guy that can play deep to protect against the deep passes down the field, but he also can come near the line of scrimmage and make the tackles in the run game. Green so fast, you have to back off of him by because you don't want him to run by you and go deep down the field. So that time he breaks the out route, the quarterback puts it right on target, and he makes the catch just short of the first down marker.
The Saints go with the dime formation here on defense. Hand off.
First down by the offense in the red zone. And, you know, if you're on the defensive side, You don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
The Bengals on offense here to start the second quarter.
Stepping up to the line at the 10.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap. On target with Tyler Eifert. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Second and goal from the 4. Bernard takes it across and he's in for the touchdown. Phil, we're early second quarter and things suddenly are all back to square one. All tied up after that touchdown.
This game is shaping up to be something special. I like the feel of it. It's exciting. Can't wait to see what happens here in the rest of this quarter.
The Saints getting set to return the kickoff. Murphy's running this one out. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Saints take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
Well, it's going to be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy and it was well done by their offense. And I think when you talk about situations like this, it really comes down to one thing. Can the offensive line continue to dominate?
Second down now. The Bengals defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel.
Look out. They're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Breeze taking off. Intercepted by Reggie Nelson. He's brought to a halt. Maybe that pick will be a momentum builder for this team at the start of the second.
Well, I know the offensive coordinator sitting over there going, I sure hope so. So he's not happy the way his team has played on the offensive side so far. Give him a play, catch the defense by surprise, and get this lead.
We'll go ground. Going to lose yards here.
Coming to the line at the 32.
They bring in the extra tight end. Second down and 11. Bernard off the left side. It'll be third down. Press coverage all the way. From the shotgun. And they sack him on third down. And they force the quick three and out. Huber is back now. He'll be punting. That punt could not have been better struck. And now the defense has the advantage with the opposition, with their backs to their own end zone. Backs to the wall for the offense. Breeze lines up in the pistol. And Ingram's handed the football. And it's Reggie Nelson in on that last play.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Ingram lines up in the backfield.
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing the play to the receivers by giving them hand signals.
Watson's tackle right at the 35. And now we reach the two-minute warning here in the second quarter. First down here.
Ingram carries the football.
And this will go for a loss as Atkins that time was in on the stop.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt.
The Saints lined up in the pistol.
Second and 12.
Malaluga has the sack.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take him down behind the line of scrimmage.
So they get to the quarterback on that last play. Third down coming up.
The Saints will look to get to the 45 to pick up a first down.
Stands in the pocket. Almost out. And it's a takeaway. Tackles made
just before halftime. And the defense with the fumble recovery has set up the offense now for a possible quick strike and the lead at the intermission.
Yeah, you're right, Jim. I love watching great defense. That's what we saw that time. You, on the other hand, it's always about the offense. You want to be entertained, but I like the physical part of defense.
To the ground. And Bernard is brought down. He's now averaging 6 yards a carry on the day.
Only 34 yards to the end zone.
Second down and 6. Toss to the outside. And Bernard is brought down. The Saints are going to burn the first of their 3 timeouts right here. That last play was a run. Third down coming up.
The Bengals will set up. The 28 is the first down line. Dalton will take it from the gun. Dalton sends it to Green.
And he's tackled. Absolutely picked up the first down.
You got to be able to adjust when you run these drag routes across the field. The throw cannot always be right on target. Can you reach behind, make the catch, and keep going full speed? That's the sign of a good receiver.
The give. Good for only a yard. Defense now signaling for a timeout. It's now second down.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
From the gun, Dalton. On the way, third down. Playing press coverage to the outside. Here's the handoff. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. The Saints signal for the timeout, and they have none remaining.
36-yard field goal attempt coming up.
And he puts it through for 3.
It's a field goal just before the intermission to move them in front.
When you make a field goal late in the second quarter, Jim, it just eases the tension of your football team, of the coaches, and even the fans are happy sometimes when you take a lead late in the second quarter.
And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Saints are set to take the field again on offense after a crazy sequence that didn't go their way. That turnover led to turnover points. And now let's see if the offense can get that back, Phil.
Yeah, listen, I know they're going to be motivated because after they turned the football over last time, the coaches took them to the sideline and just gave them heck, that's for sure. That's a good way of seeing it. So motivation, can't make those kind of mistakes. You've got to go out there and be much better.
First down at the 19. Breeze on the move.
Breeze connects with Colston.
Shakes off the hit. Watson's taken down at the 46. The teams head to the locker room. And we'll be heading to the studio to our pal Larry Ridley as you watch the NFL on EA Sports. With this kick, the second half is underway. And now Tate. And he
runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Bengals come out to open up the second half, and they were hitting on all cylinders in the first half, Bill.
Yeah, be smart here in the second half, Jim. When you start out, just find out what the defense is thinking, and once you get a feeling about what they're going to do, then you start taking some chances.
The Bengals from the 27. And the catch is made by Giovanni Bernard. The pass play was good for five. Second and five coming up. Hand off.
There you go, man.
Burns able to read that play and make the hit.
Saints defensive coordinator, my gosh, he is one happy guy. Anytime you get in the backfield and stop a runner and make him lose yards, that's some good stuff.
The Bengals all bunched up here as they get set at the line. Andy Dalton in the shotgun formation. Looking to go down the field here.
Oh my God.
That's reception number two for him.
That's what you want to do, is get a first down, especially when you're on top. Keep the clock moving. Keep the defense guessing. Make them react instead of attack.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. They'll run it.
Thank you, man.
Tackle made by Bird that time.
Bernard's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
Dalton's going to take it from the gun. It's Jones.
That's a good job by the receiver running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
Dalton's completion percentage 70% on the day. The Bengals come to the line. The first down marker is at the 24. Dalton's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Dalton delivers it to Bernard.
The Bengals are really a true football team. Their defense, we know it's good. They don't want to just rely on it. The offense, nice job picking up that first down. Eat the clock up. Keep the pace of the game on your side. Small lead here in the second half. That was a good job.
Dalton's now completed four in a row. The Bengals take it from the 23. Tackle made by Bird that time.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second and four. Right back to him once more.
Almost as good as before.
Made by Bird that time.
Bernard's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Third and two here after the run. Two tight ends on the field here. And he'll hand it off to the fullback.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now it becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
Breaking huddle at the 10. They need to get the playoff. They'll run it with him again. Charging ahead. Runs it across for the touchdown.
Like, this is not the right way to drive.
Those points may have made the lead in
surmount. Just a little thing. Like, none of my guys get there again.
Sometimes you get in a situation like this, don't look at the scoreboard. Just think about going out and executing one play at a time. And you hope if you do that somewhere in the fourth quarter, you can find a way to get back into this game.
Murphy's got a chance for a return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. The Saints talk things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
First down at the 25. Makes the catch. Gains 15.
Well, when your team is behind, what do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
launching it deep. And a near pickoff that time by Nelson.
I think that's the hardest pass a defensive back has to defend. The long throws down the field.
Hey, now we're
you have to wait till the last defensive back.
He's complaining about how it's a pick. Play. But I mean, really, truly, that's equal. We're not an equal.
The Saints will take the snap from the 40.
Pitch.
Breeze connects with Holston. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. The football sits at the 40. Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. The final quarter underway now with this snap. Carlos Dunlap, he's got the sack.
This might not be nice to see, but every once in a while it's kind of fun to watch the quarterback get sacked like that. Good job by the defensive end.
Second down coming up. Breeze from the shotgun. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. Third and 10 coming up. The Saints get set at the line, needing to get to the 30 for a first. The Saints will take the snap from the 40. The hit knocks the ball out, incomplete.
What? Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose. The quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Intercepted. They bring him to the turf.
Isn't it awesome on the defensive side where you have linebackers can make plays like that? Getting that interception. It's not always defensive backs that get to make those plays. Linebackers can do it too.
The Bengals will take the snap from the 35. Bernard off the left side. The Bengals now move the chains. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day. Come to the line and it's first down. The Saints with a nickel look here on defense. They'll go ground and tackle down at the 49-yard line.
I guess you'd say he's like a quarterback. You can't complete them all. And this running back.